and welcome to this week's show. And as we always do, let's take a quick look back at some previous action.
On last week's show, we saw what happens when you try to drive on a surface more suitable for golf. And what happens when you don't try your brakes after a Ford? The Finns, well, they were going mad again. This is John Robson having a small accident. Later in the show, he'll have a big one. And Mab's Bank, otherwise known as Launch Control at Lyddon Hill, did its bit to liven things up again. In this week's programme, the rallycross action does get a little more serious. The Finns find yet more ways to wreck their cars. And we have, by comparison, some fairly low-key action from British events. This is the Acceleration Heart of England Rally in 1995, and is staged through the grounds of Cornbury Park. So ask yourself this: how, with so many trees around, does this driver manage to spin right through the middle of them without hitting any? The Heart of England Rally was an old tarmac event, as was the London Rally, which was held the same year. Therefore, because it was called a tarmac rally, the crews expected to spend all their time on the tarmac. But the organisers had a surprise for them, and they spent a lot of time on the slippery stuff. Fortunately, the cars were starting at 1 minute intervals and not 30 seconds, otherwise a couple of crews could have had a nasty shock here. This was the very first corner of the very first stage of the rally, and further down the road, it got even worse. The event was called the London Rally because it was held near London, in much the same way that you'd call a rally held in Liverpool the Manchester Rally. Several stages of the event were held at Brooklands, the famous old racing circuit. And a tricky right here caught out virtually all the crews, for the simple reason that as you came over the bridge, the road seemed to curve to the right, when in fact you had to turn hard right through a hole in the fence onto very muddy brown tarmac.
There are only four cars that got round that corner without getting it wrong, and it's rumoured that all of those had done an illegal recce. Let's go over to Finland now, where even if they did do an illegal recce, they'd probably still crash.
As we've seen so many times on Out of Control, the Finnish camera crews and the Finnish spectators know exactly where to stand to guarantee them several hours of mind-numbing entertainment. In other words, where drivers are going to make a complete how's your father of things. laps. Luckily for us, they don't pass that information on to the drivers who are taking part in the rally. And as we move further down the field and the drivers get less and less experienced, then the accidents inevitably start to get bigger. The crew of this Mini are quite lucky to get away unhurt as the car finishes completely upside down next to a big drainage pipe. It's very wet and slippery here anyway, which makes it all the harder for the drivers to keep it on the road. Well, at least these drivers. But the spectators are, as ever, on hand to help the ailing car on down the road again. Of course, if the spectators stand too close to the stage, they're likely to get pebble dashed. This driver probably thought that this was a perfectly controlled slide, guaranteed to impress the watching fans. Well, he'll be able to find out what they thought when he walks back to collect his wheel. This Skoda, though, hits the scenery a little bit too hard and stops quite quickly. Is this a larder? What self-respecting budding Finnish rally star drives a larder? What he doesn't know is that there is a fast flowing stream there. The co-driver carefully tries to get out, but makes one drastic mistake. But I suppose that in the end, he's lucky just to get his feet wet. But just as they clear out of the way, along come their teammate in an identical car. And make a right pig's ear of it. They must be tree fellas. Both are unhurt, but the driver has been winded by the impact. And whilst they move the wreckage, some of the more cautious spectators try to calm down the other crews. And I suppose that standing in the middle of the road is a good way to slow people down. But with the car moved, the drivers are left to get on with it again. But it's not just the crews who are at risk here. And then, just when it looks like it might be calming down a little, now that really is a bit of a shaker. To be honest, you wouldn't think that there was any way that the crew could get out unhurt after a head-on impact with a tree. But remarkably, they both did. Shaken, but smiling. Extraordinary, really, isn't it? Let's get virtual commentator's view on this one.
Well, as you can see, he just oversteps the mark slightly. And when the car takes off, well, the crew are just passengers, and then it's a bit like a rocket launch, really, isn't it? Or a big woodpecker going at a tree trunk, tap, tap, tap.
So now the spectators think that they really do want to slow the rest of the cars down. After all, nobody wants to see anyone get hurt. But after a while, they get bored of that and let them start crashing again. Even when your car isn't moving, it's in danger on a rally like this.
Mad as ever, that lot. Now it's time for a break.
You see, it's not only the Finns who are completely incompetent.
Hello again. Later in the show, we've got our usual rallycross action and a bit more from Finland. But for now, we're staying in Britain.
For as long as people have been rallying, there have been good and bad drivers. And for every Colin McRae, there's at least 100 David Winstanleys. Good fast drivers, though, drive with a speed and precision that can leave you breathless at times, as you can see from this selection of shots from the Scottish Rally just a few years ago. It's hard to believe that all these are front-wheel drive cars, so sideways are the drivers getting them. Each driver seems to get closer and closer to the inside of the bend and the cameraman, until, as is the case with the Mitsubishi, there seems to be almost no gap at all. It's possible that rallying is more competitive now than it was 20 or 30 years ago, and therefore drivers have to be right on the limit to be in with any sort of a chance. And it's a fine line between staying on the road and flying off it. This is David Higgins at the end of the Castle Ore stage, and he quickly discovered that the best way to finish a stage was by going backwards, and there's nothing against that in the rules. But it was all a bit more serious for John Robson in his Vauxhall Corsa. This was a big high-speed crash, and both the crew members looked like they could be quite badly hurt. While I shot off up the road to put the warning triangle out for the following crews, John found the energy to get himself out of the car. And with his co-driver already safe, the incident didn't turn out half as bad as it first looked. As a testament to the car's strength, its roll cage was intact. And can you believe it? They drove the car out of the stage, and a few weeks later, John was out in it again, ready to cause even more havoc. Our rallycross accidents have been mainly light-hearted over the past few months, but here too, we see that there is a very fine line between a simple accident and a disaster. This is Lyddon Hill, and the Metro of Wilt Gollop slides out of control, hitting the bank and ricochets across the road, where it's hit by the RS200 of Gary Baker. Both cars are destroyed by the impact, with Gollop's catching fire with him still in it. He struggles to get free, but the marshals are quickly on the scene to help him walk away. And Will out of the car. Full credit to the marshals, who, magnificent as ever, and with no thought as to their own safety, quickly helped Gollop from the car. Marshals are an integral part of motorsport, an unpaid group of volunteers, without whom events like this wouldn't happen. In fact, all motorsport wouldn't happen without marshals, so full marks to the men in orange. The cars, meanwhile, are completely trashed, but both drivers were okay. Accidents continue to happen in rallycross, and they do have the tendency to be big ones, with some unusual incidents as well. It's almost romantic, isn't it? As we've seen before, controlling these cars in the wet isn't the easiest of tasks. At least not for these drivers anyway. And we know that some of the driving can be a bit touchy-feely, shall we say. But when the driver of the blue Mini caught the back of the red Fiesta, it looked a bit like he just didn't want to run off the track. Rather than that, he wanted to batter the Fiesta. The Fiesta driver obviously thinks otherwise though, and he nudges the Mini before chasing him off down the circuit like a dog looking for a scrap. And eventually he catches the Mini and sideswipes him off the track, just like a thug bottling someone. And as for these two, it's almost as if they were joined at birth.
That was a bit like dodging car racing, wasn't it? Now it's back to Finland for the final part of the programme.
As we've seen so many times in this series, when it comes to having accidents, the Finns don't do things by halves. And if they get the chance, they'll have a big one. And then bless them, with the help of the spectators, they'll do their best to get going again, only to travel a bit further down the road and have another one. No, the car isn't crushed. They're just upside down in a ditch, as this hapless spectator has just found out. And if this chap touches that wheel, heaven knows where he'll finish up. This is one of those corners that gives the Finns the chance to really show their ability to crash. A quick check of the notes to see whose mistake it was. And if the co-driver doesn't unhitch himself soon, he'll be going with the car. It's a pretty dusty day for this type of job, and everyone is getting covered in it. You'd think that there were only so many ways that someone could have an accident in a rally car, wouldn't you? But the Finns always seem to manage to come up with something else. And at the end of the day, there's another Finnish field full of Finnish rubbish.
And to finish off this week, it's time for our top 10. We'll be right back. join us again next week for the final show in the series.